Hi and welcome to this another one of the Tech Geeks videos. Today I'm just going to show you a performance review of the Sophos Gen 2 XGS 108. We've had some good success with some of the other ones that we've been testing. So we're just going to test this with security services turned off, security services turned on, and then we're just going to do its SSL inspection speeds as well. So just to show you what we've got in here, we've connected up the 2.5 gigabit a second Ethernet port. I think if we just have a look at networking here, it should show you the WAN and the LAN are both at 2.5 gigabits a second, which is the fastest speed obviously this device can give you. Then in firewall rules, because that's where it's all governed, we have turned off, just so you can see down here, there's no web filtering running. No inspection there, no application control, no intrusion prevention. Then in our network, we have a 10 gigabit a second IPERF 3 server and a few Linux test servers around. So out of the box, let's just throw this up. This device is sitting behind the firewall with that. So let's just give that a speed test using 5 threads. You can see that we're sitting between 500 and 600 megasecond, which isn't too bad a speed for this small, fairly entry-level box. Just see if we end up with a few more streams, whether we can push that any faster. There was a 684 in there, but it seems to be that with 5 streams, it's somewhere between 500 and 600 megasecond, which is, you know, in all fairness, pretty good for this box. So what we're just going to go and do now, we're just going to go and turn on all of those security services. So let's put a default workplace policy on here, scan anything that's already unencrypted, and we're not going to do this for the moment. We'll do the SSL in a minute. Let's put a default risk 4 and 5 on, and let's put a general policy on here and save this. Now I'm hoping that we won't probably see a lot of difference, but let's see what we get once this rule has applied. So let's again go back to our test server. Obviously our results that were there before, let's just clear those so it's a little bit easier to see. And let's run it with 10 threads. All right, we've actually got a slightly faster speed than we had before. Again, I'm not seeing really much difference in how this is performing with all of those functions turning on, which I think is actually a really good testament to this device. I think it has enough CPU to do what it needs to do. We're not certainly getting 2.5 gigabits a second. We're certainly not getting 1 gigabit a second, but we are getting consistency between both of it. And as it learns how the stream should go, it's obviously fast passing some of that through as well. So a pretty good result there if you're looking for a device, you know, to sit on a 500 meg line. But what we're now going to do is going to do a little few change arounds. We're going to use an open test, an open test server HTTPS test tool. So I'm just going to get those servers set up, and then we'll actually enable HTTPS on this device, and we'll actually see what we can get as throughput. Okay, so just to run through what we've done, in our firewall rule, we have changed this to use the web proxy. We have our de-encryption policy running in here and is on. And then in web, because essentially we're not, the server I'm using doesn't have a trusted certificate installed, I didn't want to do that. All I've done is untick the box for block invalid certificates. So if we now go to our little Linux box that's here, this is connected to our open test server, and is now, I've rebound this so it's using 443, so it's doing a true check of that speed. So this is the test. This is really a massive push for a device of this size to see what it can do. So it'll be very interesting. Remember, we saw normal 400, between 500 and 600 megabits a second for general content that's running through it. This is obviously 100, 150 megasecond lower. Upload probably doing slightly less of the encryption or the decryption maybe, but let's just see what our final results are, because I don't think they're going to be too far off our previous one. So if we take the fastest speed of those as being the result, it's probably about 50 or 60 megasecond below what we were seeing when we just did a normal standard speed test. So it's again still being able to do all of that SSL inspection and not deliver us too much performance issues. So again, if you've got a line that's around about 500 megaseconds, this is a perfect thing for it. This is the XGS 108. It's only the second one up in the starting point. So doing this is a great little unit and a great price point. So hopefully you found this speed review useful. Head on over to our YouTube channel. We've got plenty more information on how to configure Sophos, other reviews, performance reviews of some of the other models, plenty of box openings and everything along those lines as well. So why don't you subscribe and stay up to date?